Hi, I'm Dr. Frank Gerges from Sinus and Allergy Wellness Center of North Scottsdale. Another question that has been brought to my attention from some patients is, I can breathe great through one side of my nose, but the other side is blocked up. Why is that the case? Oftentimes, if you tilt your head up and you look at the structure that separates one nostril from the other side, this is a structure called the columella. Really, it's actually the end of the septum. And in some patients, if that's shifted from side to side, that can suggest that there may be a septal deviation inside. Another thing that can cause nasal blockage would be a septum that's farther back inside your nose, but if the septal columella looks like it's nice and straight, there could be a septal deviation that's still taking place on one side. So seeing your doctor, seeing your nose and throat doctor can be very efficient at finding out why you're breathing from one side and you're not breathing through the other side. Other possibilities, we could have nasal polyps inside the nasal cavity that's causing it. Sometimes patients will have polyps on one side, but not on the other side. Turbinate structures work inside the nose to filter the air that we breathe through the nose. They warm, they clean, they humidify. If one turbinate is real large and the other one's small, well, that can also cause an asymmetry of the functional capability of the inside of the nose. And then finally, there's other structures called septal swell bodies. These are turbinate-like swelling that occur along the septum that can also add to blockage. Finally, another possible cause would be nasal valve collapse. If you watch my nose when I breathe in real fast, you can see that my nasal valve collapses. So I have a nasal airway obstruction coming from an instability of the outside of my nose. Here in the Sinus and Allergy Wellness Center, we have ways that we can help to restore breathing and eliminate that nasal collapse. Thank you.